Alrighty, what do we have here? Oof, the most awkward of hands, the hand that has two lands that come into play, untapped, or tapped rather. I was wondering when this was going to actually happen, because we only have like 14 green sources that come into play on tap turn one, which is I guess still reasonable, but let's see, I'm playing first. Yeah, I think I still keep. It's like mediums. Yeah, it's kind of slow, but we can go like turn one Cinderglade, turn two suspend Valakut into Secured Tribuilder. So still something. Okay, I would guess that Shambling Vent is something that we want to see. Yeah, let's just play a Tribuilder. We play Tribuilder, then yeah, we get a mountain, cast Search for Tomorrow. Flooded Strand, some kind of control deck. Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what my opponent's playing. Esper Control. Is this getting mana leaked? It is. All right, well, just gonna ha kind of hope that this game goes kind of long so that our Valakuts can just start chunking our opponent's life total. Let's go ahead and play Tribuilder. My opponent wants to mana leak that, go ahead. And you know, I mean, I'm not sure, but like it's possible we just don't sack this Tribuilder if my opponent doesn't have a white source next turn, just to start attacking. Esper Charm. Target player discards two cards. That is unfortunate. Yeah, I'm just gonna go for Tribuilder. Or sorry. I'm just gonna go for Primeval Titan. Ooh, Esper Charm. This is a little bit risky though. Because if I drew through the breach, my opponent just dies on the spot. But I mean, you get my opponent got their value. Like I discarded Summoner's Pact and Scapeshift. Like just getting that last card out of my hand seems more important. That's how you leave yourself kind of potentially dead, right? But my opponent is just so far up on cards now. Well, I guess that's another reason. Because you're so far up on cards, it's just you don't necessarily need that. I guess at the same time, I could have drawn a Primeval Titan or a Summoner's Pact for my turn, and then it, you know, you would feel kind of silly. All right, time to deal some damage. All right, the old every draw step is something relevant. Almost every draw step is relevant for us, which is good. Also, again, I'm not fetching because I can draw my second Valakut. Okay. Does my opponent just have nothing? Also, if my opponent activates Shambling Vent, I'm probably just gonna kill it. Okay, here we go. Here's a win condition. All right. Still not fetching. Wanna see what I draw? Okay, well, fetching cannot kill Elspeth, so It's a race, but I don't think we're winning this race. Yeah, we don't have two. This deck right now doesn't have a whole lot against control matchups, mostly because control decks don't really exist in Modern, or they're not very popular. All right, those were not good draws. I guess if my opponent just like doesn't have a counterspell, we can win. I'm just running one out here to see if my opponent counters it. Oh, one cool play that my opponent can do is Esper Charm me in response to Through the Breach. All right. I guess we're not technically... No, we have. There's nine attackers. All right, you know what? I've had enough. All right, that wasn't great for us. What do we have? Nothing. Cool. No, we really do have nothing, though. We take out some of this. We bring in a 4-mana 4/4. A Reclamation Sage. Maybe some Land Destruction. And call it a day. Oh, we still need one more card. Okay. A Hornet Queen. Yeah, we have nothing for this matchup. I mean, I guess again a second Scapeshift would be good, but you know, right? Like, if blue control decks were more popular, we could have definitely tooled our deck to be good against them. This deck is not meant for that. You know, we could have had cards like, you know, Guttural Response or Summoning Trap, things like that, but yeah, we don't. Oh, this is pretty great against Esper Charm. All right, I'm in. Can we live the dream? Please? All right. Let's go ahead and fetch Stomping Ground. Suspend. Farseek. That was actually a good draw. Farseek. Stomping Ground. So you get Stomping Ground if you know you're going to get to have two basics in play. So right now we have a Mountain and a Search for Tomorrow, which is going to go off next turn. But if you don't think you're going to have two basics in play anytime soon, then you get the Cinderglade, because that way if you draw like Cinder, you want less chances of drawing a Cinderglade, because that's a land that's going to come into play tapped. If that makes any sense. Let's go ahead and get Mountain. And yeah, I'm going to go ahead and play the Courser to try to get some value. We did not get value. I guess that's like a reasonable card. I actually just want to play Tribalder just to get another attacker in there. Like, we're not going to draw Primeval Titan next turn. It would... Yeah, I mean, I guess my opponent can Esper Charm me right now, but... I mean, that's okay too, because we get to just discard the Baloth. Okay, my opponent has a super slow hand. And not sacking Tribalder. And let's... Alright, you got the mana leak, you got the mana leak. Okay, no mana leak. I guess they could have Wrath. Is my opponent teaching me how to pronounce it? Oh, why are they're doing it in my main phase? That means I can hit another land. Yes. Yeah, I don't want to draw a tribe builder, so let's just do it again. We might be able to hit a land. Just kidding. Right, we have millions of mana now. And our opponent's at 11 life. All right. Ooh, Tectonic Edge. That's a good one. I would say we got decent value there, though. Oh, wow. That's a good one. And let's go ahead and attack. Let's play Tribe. Oh, wait, my opponent didn't have Mana Leak, right? I should have played Baloth first. Oh, punished. I guess that wasn't too bad. Yeah, I should have played around Mana Leak and played the Baloth first. I was just like kind of on autopilot there. Yeah, I mean, sure, my opponent had to kill my Valakut there, but like that keeps them, kind of lower on mana, which is fine. Do I want to draw this through the breach? I don't think so. At the same time, having this in play gives me the option of killing Shambling Vent, but also just drawing a bunch of mountains seems pretty good with Valakut in play. And the sacrificing end of turn gives us 9 mana, meaning that if we draw Primeval Titan, it can't get mana leaked. As opposed to like doing it on my turn, on my upkeep, just because we'll have a land untapped. All right, we only have one mountain left. Is this an Esper Charm? Okay. Yeah, we just got too far ahead on lands. Yeah, and Valakut, hitting that Valakut was obviously huge. All right. So yeah, my opponent just on pure Esper control and had a really, really slow start there. But again, I mean, this is our deck. We got not a whole lot here. I mean, really, our hope is to just draw the Valakut. I really wanted a fourth Valakut in the deck, but right now there's 16 green sources. If you were to add a Valakut, you'd probably have to cut like a mountain, which I don't think it's great. I don't know if you want to play five mountains. Let's see, five mountains, four Stomping Grounds, and two Cinder Glades. I guess that's not terrible. But I like the like minimum 16 green sources there because of all the I'm not gonna lie. I tried adding a fourth Valakut, and when I did, I went down on a green source, and I mean, it's a small sample size, but there were a decent amount of games where I really just wanted to make sure that I had that green source. It's got three lands, two Summoners Pact, Through the Breach. I don't think I can mulligan this. It's not a great hand, but I mean, essentially it's three lands, three creatures, and a Through the Breach. Yeah, I agree with your assessment of that game. So yeah, here again, I think I'm gonna go ahead and Wooded Foothills for a Cinder Glade, because I don't want to draw any right now. Cast Farseek. And let's get another Cinderglade. Yeah, because I don't mind drawing Stomping Grounds and playing them untapped if I have to. For example, like next turn is a perfect example, right? If we drew Cinderglade, we would not be able to play Farseek and Explore, right? But now that we've gotten that out of our deck, you know, because the option is Cinderglade or Stomping Ground, like drawing a Stomping Ground, I wouldn't mind just going Farseek into Explore. Packs are not great against a deck with a bunch of counter spells, but kind of hoping to draw, I guess, a land next turn. Just any untapped land. Oof. That's Farseek and get a Stomping Ground. Actually, I could have gotten a Mountain there. Oh, no. Never mind. I have both of my Cinderglades. If my opponent Esper charms me, I can, like, Summoner's Pact for Absent and Baloth. I wonder if that's even good. Alright, my opponent chose to draw two cards. Smart choice. Alright, let's go ahead and cast Search for Tomorrow. Let's get a Mountain and play Explore. Just develop our board as much as we can. This is not good because we have zero pressure on our opponent, but on the draw, it's going to be hard to resolve some early threats anyways. My opponent going deep. I can get behind some Esper control. Yeah, this is one of those games, yeah, I want to just keep drawing land, so I want to be able to set up a situation where I go end of turn through the Breach, untap, Scape Shift. That's like kind of like my main game plan here. But here, like, I can end of turn through the Breach, but if my opponent counters it, it's not 100% that I'm going to be able to just, like, punish my opponent, so I probably just play out the Secret Tribe Elder. And then I guess my opponent has to decide whether or not to counter this or remand it or whatever. Don't think I would Cryptic Command this. We have a lot of really expensive cards in our hand. Just need mana. Just let it resolve. Come on, it's just a Tribe Elder. It's just a Tribe Elder. Come on. It's harmless. Look at this thing. It needs like sticks to walk around. You gotta treat your elders with respect. Come on. Please. Alright, so, yeah. Let's try to come up with a game plan here. Yeah, I don't want to use my summoner's packs right now just because, like, that basically commits my mana for two turns. Okay. I think my opponent's just going to continue to draw cards. Maybe not. Yep. Yeah, my opponent at this point knows about Obstinate Baloth and does not want to give me that extra card, which is very reasonable. And here I'm just going to block Sack. Now I think I can get a forest. Yeah. Because I want as many mountains as my in my deck. I have the five mountains in play. Yeah, I'll play the land. I don't think I'm going to get spell pierced. Seems very unlikely that my opponent would have that card. Three, four. Another Snapcaster Mage. God, so much value. Ooh, Mystical Teachings. Okay. Probably for some kind of counterspell. Yeah, so now we're going to have to try to fight through counters. Now, Mystical Teachings gives this deck some inevitability. And it's going to be difficult. And we're going to try our best, but... going to need like multiple Through the Breaches here. White Sun Zenith. Okay, you know, I'm actually kind of happy that that was the card because like my opponent's probably not going to be able to cast that for a while. Let's play a Through the Breach. Okay, got negated. All right, now we're gonna just start basically just running out threats and hoping for the best. What's the worst threat in our hand? Probably the Hornet Queen. Surgical Extraction on Through the Breach. Okay, well that does not do anything right now. So I play out the Hornet Queen, play the land. That way, if I draw another land, I can play Primeval Titan and at the very least play around Mana Leak. Okay. We have a Queen online. Hero's Downfall. Okay. Alright, so my opponent does have a White Sun Zenith here. I might just trade off a Snapcaster for an Insect here, though. My opponent does have a White Sun Zenith. That's, like, not irrelevant. Alright. Thoughtseize. Okay. Yeah. I wonder if I should have like an Eternal Witness in my deck. Alright. 4, 5, 6. Time to just start running it out there. Yep. Three, four, five, six. So my opponent now has the mana to 3, 4, 5. My opponent now has the mana to flash back Teachings for Mana Leak. So I should probably sack my Tribe Elder here. I'm gonna get a forest. I mean, if my opponent had Mana Leak, they would have played it last turn, but I mean, they cast Remand. Also, once again, yeah, they have Teachings in their graveyard, so they have access to 8 mana. And I don't really mind if my opponent Tectonic Edge is here, because then, once again, they won't have mana to flashback for Mana Leak. Does my opponent have like a Shadow of Doubt or something? Flashback Teachings for Shadow of Doubt. That seems overly aggressive. Right. Let's attack first. So flashback teachings for remand is my guess here. Wait, flashback teachings for mana leak? But I can pay. Curious. All right, we're going to get some tribe elders now. Oof. We had the thing is we had the, even my opponent mana leaks the tribe elder, we just summoner's pack for another one. Bam. Actually, I should have paid the life. If I pay the life, I could still get another tribe elder. All right. Well, we managed to. I did not think we were going to win this game. My opponent drew so many cards. That was weird. All right. Well, got lucky.